Okay, magandang araw sa inyong lahat. So our topic for today is chapter 3 na tayo, ano? So chapter 1 and 2 is tapos na. So alam na natin lahat ng soil properties and also how to classify the soil, ano, in different standard USDA, USCS and ASTO. So ngayon lipat na tayo sa Chapter 3. So, yung chapter 3 natin is the flow of water through soils. So, another properties or characteristic of the soil na kung saan yung ating water ay magpo-flow doon sa ating soil. Ano? So, si Darcy's Law. So, Darcy's Law siya. Okay. So, nag-examine, ano? Nag-experiment and yan pa ganyan yung kanyang eksperimento, ano. So ito yung ating soil specimen and meron tayong porous stone dito, nilagyan niya, and magkabilang dulo is nilagyan niya ng piezometer o yung dyan makukuha yung level ng tubig, ano, at a certain point. And dito ito yung inlet. So, yung tendency ng water is to flow from the inlet pamula dito hanggang doon at doon hanggang doon at lumabas hanggang doon sa outflow. So, magkakaroon ng level ng tubig dito and level ng tubig dito from the first point of the soil specimen up to the last point of the soil specimen having a length L. Okay, length L. Cross-section. Nakatingin tayo sa section AA. Okay. And, yan. So, yung cross-section niya is bilog. Okay, bilog yan. So, cylinder. So, yung experiment ni Darcy, ganito ang nangyari. So, Darcy's laws governs, nag-govern daw that the flow of water through soils. So, Darcy, 1856, proposed that the average flow velocity through soil daw. Okay, average flow velocity through soil is proportional to the gradient of the total head. Okay, so anong ibig sabihin nun? Yung ating average velocity daw. So, pag sabi average velocity, so, siya na yung pinaka mean velocity, ano? Ayan. So, that is proportional to the gradient of the total head daw. Ayan. Gradient of the total head. Ano ba yung gradient of the total head? Yan yung ating hydraulic conductivity, hydraulic gradient I. Okay, which is equivalent to H over L. Yung H ay yan yung ating difference in head. Ayan o. So, ito yung Okay, velocity, the average velocity is equals to KI. Yung K is the coefficient of permeability or the hydraulic conductivity. Okay, yan yung K. Okay? And yung I, ganyan yan. So, H over L. Yung H is the difference in head. And ito yon. Diba, ito may level dito ng tubig, difference in the level of water dito. So, yan yung ating head. Okay? And, H over L, hydraulic gradient. Yung L is yung length na pinagtrabela ng tubig dun sa soil. Okay? Therefore, yun yung length of the soil. So, H over L yon. Okay? So, hydraulic gradient, coefficient of permeability or the hydraulic conductivity is in meter per second or meter per day. So, yun yung unit niya. Okay. And the N, so, sabi pati niya, yung seepage velocity or the V sub S is equivalent saan? Average velocity over porosity N. Okay. So, seepage velocity. Okay. So, seepage velocity is V over N or the average velocity over porosity N. Okay. So, yun. Okay? And the discharge. Paano makuha yung discharge nung ano? Kasi, di ba, dumalo yung tubig dito. Dapat makuha natin yung discharge Q. Okay? So, nakuha natin yung velocity, average velocity, and also the seepage velocity. Okay? So, yung ating average discharge Q is equivalent to, syempre, velocity times the cross-sectional area. Velocity, average velocity times, ano, the cross-sectional area nung ating soil specimen. Okay, so yung discharge is equal to KIA or KIA. Para madali, sorry, KIA, discharge. Pagka yung, flow of water through soil, ano, by Darcy's law. Okay, yan. So, balik tayo dyan. So hindi yung ating VN, ha? Hindi ito yon. Hindi yung velocity, average velocity. Kaya nga average discharge eh. So yung velocity dapat is the average velocity ang gagamitin. And then yung cross-sectional, yung area, yung cross-section ito, which is ito. Okay, and usually in diameter, in cylindrical yan. So diameter ang bilog yung ating cross-sectional area. Ngayon, process method ano, para makuha yung K na yan, itong K. So, what is that? K is the hydraulic conductivity or the coefficient of permeability. Ito yung capacity of the soil or the coefficient of the soil capacity to for the water to flow on it, ano yan. So in meter per ano daw siya, so naka-indicate kanina, usually in meter per second, ayan, meter per second or meter per day. Okay, yun yung ano ba, isang metro ang tinravel ng tubig. Okay, per second 1 meter per second, sa isang segundo ay isang metro yung tinravel ng tubig. Yun yung ating hydraulic conductivity, kung tawagin ano, or the coefficient of permeability. Okay, so madaming way para ma-determine. So depende kung ano yung ating soil sample ano. If the soil sample is coarse grained, so ano ba pagkakaiba ng coarse grained soil sa fine grained soil? So, coarse grain soil is, ibig sabihin, medyo malalaki pa yan. So, dun sa sieve number 200, kapag sieve analysis, yung na-retain sa sieve number 200 is greater than 50%. So, coarse grain soil siya. Kapag fine grain soil naman, yung na-retained sa sieve number 200 is less than 50%. So, fine grain siya. Okay? Ngayon, determination of the coefficient of permeability. So, madami ano. So, pwedeng constant head test and falling head test. Ayan, falling head test. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng constant head test? Okay? So, ganito yung pagtetest ng soil. Okay? Meron tayong soil sample. Ito. And also may porous stone both ends, and meron tayong graduated plus cylinder, so para masukat kung ilang discharge ano, volume, kung ilang volume na dumaloy. So pag sinabing constant, yung tubig is maintain lang sa level nito, maintain lang dyan. Okay. So, kasi kapag ka coarse grain soil, di ba, masyadong ano yan, mabilis yung kanyang pagbaba ng tubig, kasi coarse grain soil sa mas mabilis yung kanyang lusot ng tubig dito, mabilis. So, ang ginagawang test is constant head test, kasi hindi natin masusukat agad kung mabilis bumaba, di ba? So, i-constant head test natin. So unlike dun sa coarse sa fine grain soil naman, falling head test ang ginagamit. Bakit falling head test? Kasi Sobrang bagal naman. Sobrang bagal ng pag-flow ng tubig dito. Kaya, falling head test yung ginagamit. Okay? Falling head test yung ginagamit. Kasi kung i-constant head natin yan, i-constant head natin ay aawas ng aawas yung tubig natin. Okay? Kasi mabagal nga eh. Kaya ang ginagamit na test is the falling head test. Okay? So, only for fine grain soil lang. Okay? Yan. So, unahin natin tong si constant head test. Okay, paano ba nasusukat yung nalalaman yung ating coefficient of permeability using this test, ano, constant head test. Okay, so the constant head test is used to determine the coefficient of permeability of a coarse grain soil. Just like what I've said a while ago, ano. So, ito, yan, constant yan, hindi siya bababa, hindi siya magbababa yung tubig, ha. So, hayaan lang mag-flow yung water papunta doon hanggang doon sa ilalim and then doon. Okay? Then ito yung pagkuha ng volume, ano? Yan. So, yung ating coefficient of permeability or the hydraulic conductivity using the constant head test permeability ay ito yung formula. So, ito lang. K coefficient of permeability is equals to velocity or the volume, sorry, volume yan, volume times the length yung length ng specimen times t yung time na nakuha yung volume. Okay, ito yung ibig sabihin, ano, yan, ito volume for v. So ito yung formula natin for hydraulic conductivity using the constant head test. So, yung V dyan is the volume of water collected in time T. Okay, collected in time T. Time interval T. Time yan. So, and H, yung H natin dyan, the constant head. So, ano ba yung constant head? So, difference between the elevation of the water surface here and the water surface here. So, ano yun? So, ito yung H. Okay? Yan. Yun yung constant head. Hindi bababa yan. Hindi bababa. Constant head. Coarse grain soil yung ating tinetest. Then, A is the cross-sectional area. So, madali lang. Madali lang yan. Cross-sectional area. Pi D squared over 4 or pi R squared. Ganyan. Area. Okay? Length. Oh, length of the soil sample. Yun yung L. And the T, duration of water collection. Halimbawa, nagsimula kayo na ang time is at 2 seconds. Then after 5 seconds, nakuha niya yung volume na ganon. Halimbawa, so ang time interval niya is 5 minutes to 3 seconds. Yun yung T natin. Yun yung time. And kapag falling head test naman, so the falling head test is used for the fine grain soil because the flow of water through this soil is too slow, so napakabagal to get reasonable measurement para makuha yung ating reasonable measurement from the constant head test. Kasi kung i-ko constant head test, may aawas yan, aawas. Okay, masyadong hindi siya accurate. So ang ginagawa, falling head test. So, from here, so, magsasali ng tubig, and then, tatanggalin yung hose o gripo, or kung ano man, and then, hahayaan lang na bumaba yung tubig papunta dun. Halimbawa, ay hanggang dito. So, H2. Hanggang H2. So, bababa. Bababa yung tubig niya. Kaya nga, falling head test siya, no? Yan. So, ganun ulit, may soil sample tayo, ito yung soil sample, and may length siya, and ito naman, porous stone, okay, porous stone, so, soil specimen, and then yung cross-section yan is, ito pa din, yung cross-section ito, so, ay, bilog, ano, bilog, and also the cross-sectional area of the pipe, so, kailangan yan, kasi, yan yung area kung saan bumababa. Masusuka, bumababa yung tubig eh. Yan yung area. Okay? Kasi nung bumaba ito, ito yung area. Yan, cross-sectional area niyan ng standpipe. Okay, kasi paglagay ng tubig dito, paglagay natin ng tubig, is ang tendency ng tubig is pababa. Pababa doon, hanggang doon, hanggang sa lumutang doon. And then, mag-awas dito. Okay? Yan. So, yung coefficient of permeability or K is ito yung formula. Okay. Okay. So, yung A dyan, yung maliit, small letter A, is the, syempre, yung ano, ito. Yan. Yung area ng ating standpipe. Area ng standpipe times the length L. Okay, nandiyan eh. Length L, yung length specimen. So, length of the soil specimen natin. Over A, big letter A. Yan yung cross-sectional area ng ating specimen. And T2 minus T1, yan yung ating time, final time and initial time. Okay. And multiplied by ln ng H1 over H2. H1 over H2. Ln. Ito yung H1 and ito yung H2. Okay. So, bakit kaya nagkaroon ng ln? So, integral, ano? Integral ng 1 over H is ln ng h, ano, then yung kanyang upper limit is h2 and the lower limit is h1, diba? So, kasi kaya nag-integral is nababa yung tubig. Okay, ayan. So yung cross-sectional area of the standpipe, so direct substitution lang. Pag nakuha nyo, alam nyo ito, alam nyo lahat yung mga dimension dyan. And yung kung alin ang H1, alin ang H2, kung ano yung L, length of the specimen, and kayo magkakabaligtad dun sa area ng standpipe and area ng soil specimen na magmamali yung sagot. Okay? So, yun. So, lecture lang muna tayo. Then, after the lecture ay example. Okay? Next is the effect of water temperature on coefficient of permeability or the hydraulic conductivity, K. So, the hydraulic conductivity of soil is a function of a unit weight of water. Okay? And thus, it is affected by a water temperature. Okay? So, yung hydraulic conductivity natin ay nagbabago yan. Okay? Depende kapag mainit ang tubig or malamig yung tubig or katamtaman lang yung tubig. So, the relationship is given by ito. Yan. Yung relationship ng K at temperature 1 and K at temperature 2 is this. Okay? Yan yun. And yung mu, yan yung ating viscosity. Lapot ng ating tubig, ano? Viscosity of water temperature at T1, ito. Viscosity of water at temperature T1, ito naman, mu sub T2, viscosity of water at temperature T2. Okay? Ito naman, K at T1 is the hydraulic conductivity at temperature 1. Ito yon. And this is the hydraulic conductivity at temperature 2. Okay? So, yung relationship daw nila, ayan, nasa taas. And yung nasa baba, unit weight of water at temperature T1. So, hindi ito times, ha? Unit weight of water at temperature T1. Ito. Hindi ito nakamulti. Subscript din itong T1 at T2, ha? Subscript din yan. Okay? So, viscosity times unit weight of water. Viscosity times unit weight of water. Okay? At ito naman, viscosity of the unit weight, viscosity at the temperature of water 2. Ito naman, viscosity at temperature of water 1. Okay, and multiply by the unit weight of water at temperature 1 and the unit weight of water at temperature 2. Okay. Yan. So, ito yung relationship. Yung relationship. Okay. Next is the flow of flow through permeable layers. Through permeable layers. So may dalawang case na pwedeng mangyari diyan. It's either yung ating water table or the flow of water is ganito yung itsura. So itong dalawang to, yung dalawang ito ay piezometer yan. Okay. And permeable layer ay ito. Yan, ito. Diyan dadalo yung tubig. Kaya nga permeable layer. And itong dalawang to, impervious. Impermeable layer. So, hindi dyan dadalo. So, dito lang dadalo yung ating tubig. Papunta doon. Okay. So, yung padalawa naman is dito dadaloy yung tubig. So, wala dito sa taas na impermeable layer. Meaning to say, yung water table, ito yung water table. So, nag-coincide dito. Okay. Walang impermeable layer dito. So, unahin natin yung isa, yung may dalawang impervious layer. So, ibig sabihin, magkaka-pressure yan dito eh. Okay. Okay. So, dalawang, ito yung soil specimen. Soil impermeable layer. Ito. Okay. And then, may slope siya, no? So, alpha. That is the slope of the permeable layer. Alpha. And yung H, yung thickness ng ating permeable layer. Okay? Big letter H yun. Okay? Yung small letter H naman is yung ating difference in head of the piezometer. And the length, ito, L yan, L. Okay? So, ngayon, yung ating hydraulic gradient, ang target nating makuha dyan, I. Okay, kasi nakuha na natin yung mga K, di ba? K. So, yung I naman. So, yung ating hydraulic gradient, tandaan nyo, lagi yan ay difference in head over yung ating length kung saan nag-travel yung ating tubig. Okay? So, kung saan nag-travel yung ating tubig. Kung ang hydraulic gradient is H over length kung saan nag-travel yung ating tubig, so, kunin natin ito dito. So, bakit naging L over cosine ng alpha? Yung ating L kung saan nag-travel yung tubig. Okay? So, kung makikita nyo dito, ito yung ating alpha. Ayan, ito. And then, ito yung layer. Layer, slope of the permeable layer, ano? And may right triangle tayo dito. Right triangle. And then, yung flow natin, yung the length of flow, ito na ba? So, hindi yan. Kasi, ang nag-flow ang water, dun sa, saan? Dun sa hypotenuse ng, ito, dito. Dito sa hypotenuse ng triangle na yan. Ito, hypotenuse. So, anong value nito? Nitong length nito. Anong value? Okay? So, alam natin na yung ating adjacent over the alpha. No? Adjacent L, kasi ito L din to eh. Okay, L. Adjacent L over itong hypotenuse, sabihin natin C. Okay? C. Okay, dyan sa C na yan, dyan nag-travel yung tubig natin. And that is equivalent, L over C, that is equivalent to cosine ng alpha. Okay? cosine ng alpha. Ngayon, kung sa C nag-travel yung ating ano tubig, yan yung ating magiging length of the layer kung saan nag-travel yung ating tubig, ano. So therefore, yung i-cross multiply natin to, i-cross multiply natin. So yung ating C is equivalent to L over cosine ng alpha. So kaya naging ganyan. Kaya ito over L cosine ng alpha. Ano? Tandaan niyo lagi na ang hydraulic gradient o yung I is equivalent to the ratio of the H, the head of the piezometer, head of the water, difference of the water level, ano? Water level nung kung anong dalawang level na 'yon, ano? H over dun sa inlet out outlet. Okay? Then L sabi natin small letter L, yan yung ating length of the layer kung saan nag-travel yung ating tubig. And based dun sa ating figure, L over cosine ng alpha yun. Okay. Ayan. So, yun ang pagkuha. Kapag impervious material, meron dito. Impermeable material. Impermeable soil. So, dito lang nag-flow. Now, ngayon naman, paano naman kung dito lang sa baba merong impervious, dito wala. So, nasa water table ka agad yung ating tubig. Ground water table. Pre-surface, ika nga sabihin. Okay, walang impervious material, yung impermeable layer. Impervious layer. Dito lang sa baba. So, pag ganyan, yung hydraulic gradient natin is only equivalent to sine of the alpha or the sine of the angle nito. Yan, angle of the impervious mat layer. Okay? So, bakit nagkaganon? Bakit nagkaganon agad? So, sine ng alpha. Diba, ang ating I is equivalent to H over L. Tama, H over L. Okay, so nagkataon dito na yung ating ito yung di ba yung H is the difference of the dito, difference of water table. So, difference. So, ito yung magiging H natin. H, and then yung L, ito pa din yung L. Ngayon, sa nag-flow yung water dito? So, sa hypotenuse pa din. Yung hypotenuse ang kukunin natin. Okay? Hypotenuse. So, yung hypotenuse natin, kung ito ay alpha, so alpha din ito. Tama. Ayan. Tama. Alpha. So, kunin natin. So, yung ating H is alpha. Kunin ulit natin, ano? Ayan. So, H over, so, dito nag-travel. So, H over L. So, parang ganun din halos kanina, no? Kaya lang, ang nangyari kasi dito, ito yung H. Okay, yan yung H dito. Okay. Yan yun. Okay, and kinuha lang natin dito is yung length of the layer kung saan nag-travel yung soil. Okay. So dito, nangyari dito, wala nang piezometer. Eksakto na yung ating H ay ito na. Okay? So ito yung H and ito yung L natin is ito. Yan yung L. So dito nag-travel yung ating soil. So, kunin natin yan. Kunin natin yung kung saan nag-travel, ano. So, So, kung ito ay alpha, so opposite, ito, ano. We'll know that opposite H over hypotenuse, sabi natin L, is equivalent to sine ng alpha, no? sine ng alpha. Okay. L over sine ng alpha. Okay, so yung ating H is L over sine ng alpha. H over sine ng alpha. So, H daw is L over sine ng alpha. L over sine ng alpha. Ayan. And then yung ating L is approximately equal na din dun sa ano? Saan? Doon sa ating L. Kaya ang nangyari, L sine ng alpha over L. So, cancel out. So, kaya naging sine ng alpha na lang yan. Okay, yan. So, yun. Pagkuha ng hydraulic gradient yun. Okay. So, madaming sa K naman, balik tayo sa K, coefficient of hydraulic conductivity. So, madaming pwedeng formula. Nagbigay ng formula si Hazen, si Casagrande, alin pa? Casagrande, Cosini, Corman equation, and Samarasene, Huang, and Drinkwitz. Wala kayo kung paano bigkasin. Basta yan ay way, nagbigay ng mga formula yung mga taong yan ng paano pwedeng kuhanin yung coefficient of permeability. So, naka-indicate naman sa problem, i-indicate naman, halimbawa may exam, indicate na problem, use Hazen formula, use Casagrande for the K, value for K, so use the Casagrande formula, so ito yon. Okay, so unahin natin yung kay Hazen formula for fairly uniform sand. So, kapag fairly uniform sand ang ating classification, so pwede natin kunin yung ating hydraulic conductivity or coefficient of permeability, K, equivalent to C times D10 squared. Yung C, a constant that varies from 1 to 1.5. Constant yan. So, igigibin din naman yan. Ano? And yung D10, that is the effective grain size or the size of the soil specimen at 10% finer. Okay, D10. So, ang formula para makuha yung K is C D10 squared. I-squared natin. And by Casagrande for fine to medium clean sand. Okay, pag fine to medium clean sand siya, gigiven din naman niya sa problem. So, ito yung ating formula by Casagrande. Ano? 1.4 void ratio squared times K at 0.85 void ratio. Ano? So, yung void ratio, natural void ratio ito. Ito namang K na ito ay at 0.85 void ratio. Okay, saan nakukuha yan? Yung K at 0.85. Eh, this ano, sa lab na ano, sa laboratory. Laboratory. Okay? And yung K natin, hydraulic conductivity at void ratio E. Okay? At void ratio E. Next formula na nagbigay para makuha yung coefficient of conductivity permeability is the Cosine-Karman equation. So, where K is equals to C sub 1 times E raised to 3 or the void ratio over 1 plus void ratio. Okay, where K is the hydraulic conductivity at void ratio E. And C1 is a constant. Constant yan. Constant C1. Next is Samarasinhe, Huang, and Drinkwitz. Okay, so ito yung formula. K, so C, K is equivalent to C sub 3 multiplied by void ratio raised to N. So yung N is the porosity, ha? Porosity over 1 plus E. Okay, yan. So, where C, 3, and N are constant. to be determined experimentally. Yeah. So another topic is the equivalent hydraulic conductivity in stratified soil. So when we say stratified soil, so iba't iba yung ating layer ng soil. Okay, kung saan dadalo yung ating tubig. So stratified soil, halimbawa nandito yung ating tubig, water table, ang pagdalo ng tubig is papunta doon, parallel. Okay? So kaya tinatawag siyang parallel flow. Pag naman nandito ang tubig sa taas, and yan, andyan ang tubig, so ang tendency ng tubig is pababa. That is the normal flow. Ngayon, may dalawang way para makuha yan, yung equivalent hydraulic conductivity na yan. Kasi madami yan eh. Iba't iba ang hydraulic conductivity ni soil 1. Si soil 2, iba din. Si soil 3, iba din. Depende na lang dun sa daloy ng tubig kung parallel flow or normal flow. Kapag parallel flow, ito yung ating formula. The equivalent permeability in the x direction is parallel flow. So ang equation is yan. So equivalent hydraulic conductivity is equivalent to dito, K times the total H. Yung total H natin, yan yung total thickness ng ating layer. Okay, layer 1 plus layer 2 plus layer 3, thickness ng lahat ng yon. So yun yung ating H. Ito. Ito naman yung ating hinahanap. Okay? And summation lang lahat ng ating K times layer. K times layer. So, ganito mangyayari dyan. So, ang total kasi equivalent hydraulic conductivity times the total thickness H, that is equivalent to the summation of the hydraulic conductivity times the thickness of every soil. Okay, so KX sub 1, so bakit X? Kasi in the X direction yung flow. So, times Z1, yung thickness ng soil 1. Ayun, ito, thickness nito. Okay, and then ipa-plus natin yung sa soil 2. Ito yung sa soil 2. KX 2, hydraulic conductivity of the soil 2 multiplied by the thickness of the soil 2. Okay, so kung madaming layer ay K sub N times A raised to N yan. So kung tatlong layer lang, ay di hanggang dito lang tayo sa Z3. Okay, Z3, ito lang. So K sub 3 or the conductivity at soil 3 multiplied by the thickness. Ito. Yan. So ganun, pagka parallel flow, ano? Parallel flow, multiply siya, ano? Kapag naman normal flow, ito, dito. Kapag normal flow, ganito ang relationship. So, the coefficient of permeability in the Z direction is normal flow. So, sa halip na multiply, ngayon, i-divide. So, total H or the thickness, total thickness ng ating layer over, yun yung ating hinahanap, yun yung equivalent coefficient of permeability or the hydraulic conductivity equivalent. Okay? And, ganun din dito, dapat times yan, di ba? Kung parallel. So, di-divide natin pag normal flow. So, Z over, summation of Z over K. Lahat yan. So, sa ating layer, ito. So, meron tayong K1. Also, K1, papunta din doon. K2, K3. And meron tayong thickness na Z1, Z2, Z3. Okay, kung halimbawa nandito ang tubig, so ang daloy ng tubig is normal flow. Okay, so yung ating relationship between the coefficient of conductivity and the H or the total thickness ay yan. So H, total H over equivalent hydraulic conductivity is equivalent to Z1. So yung Z1, thickness ng ating first layer, over coefficient of permeability or the hydraulic conductivity ng ating soil 1. Okay, in the Z direction, so pababa. So plus Z2 or the thickness of the soil layer 2 over coefficient of permeability of the soil layer 2 in the Z direction. Okay, so bakit? Kasi yung Kx and Kz ay magkaiba ha? Magkaiba. Depende na lang sa problem kung specified na same lang yung X and Y direction of flow. Okay? Yan. Okay, yun. Ganun yung ating pagkuha ng equivalent hydraulic conductivity kapag in stratified soil. Okay? So, how about naman kapag sa aquifer? Aquifer, pag sinabing aquifer ay ayan, unconfined aquifer and confined aquifer. So, ibig sabihin, pagka confined aquifer, ayan yung water table na meron sa ibabaw na clay or impervious layer. Okay, pag unconfined aquifer naman ay ano na siya, nasa water table, wala na siya sa ibabaw na ano, na yung atmospheric pressure is in standard, no? So flow through layers of aquifers. So kung kanina ay stratified soil, so ngayon naman is in aquifers, no? So unconfined aquifer yung nasa taas and confined aquifer yung nasa baba. Okay. So yung aquifer natin horizontal yung ano, nandito yung tubig. Ito yung tubig sa kabila and then ito yung tubig sa ano. So ang flow ng water since mababa dito, papunta doon. Okay, papunta doon yung flow of water. So parallel. Tama, parallel. So magagamit natin yung formula na to. Ayan. So multiply. Okay. Kaya lang, pagkakaiba lang ay yung ating hydraulic gradient and the cross-sectional area. Okay. So kasi kukunin natin yung discharge. Eh, diba yung discharge is velocity key times the cross-sectional area. Okay. So yung equivalent coefficient of permeability is makukuha natin using this formula. So given naman yung K1 and K2 dyan, and H1 and H2 is also given. Thickness parehas siya ng ating soil, unconfined aquifer. Okay, and flow per unit width is yan, Q or the discharge. Okay, so velocity times the cross-sectional area. So velocity, average velocity natin is equivalent to K, equivalent hydraulic conductivity multiplied by the hydraulic gradient I. Kaya lang, yung hydraulic gradient natin dyan is instead na H over L lang, yung H is the difference between the water level, ano? Okay, so ito yung H. Okay. Okay. So tama, ano? So D1 minus D2, yung difference of the water level over the total length of the tinravel ng ating tubig. Okay. Sa soil na 'yan, ano, sa unconfined aquifer na 'yan. So yun yung hydraulic gradient natin. Ay yung area naman, so yung ating average, di ba, kung dito dumaloy yung average cross-sectional area nito, yan average cross-sectional area, so D1 plus D2 over 2 times the 1 meter length. Okay, 1 unit length. Okay, So ngayon naman, pagka yung ito, pag parallel to, parallel flow. Pagka naman normal flow ay ganito lang. So 'di ba kanina nag-multiply, so magagamit natin yung h over k. Okay. So this time yung h ay magiging l. Bakit? Dahil pag ganito yung ating problem na figure, ano? Ito yung magiging thickness niya, ito. Yung flow is parallel. Bakit parallel? Normal. Perpendicular. Normal. Okay? So, yung tubig, magkabila, mas mataas yung D1, mas mababa yung D2. So, ang tendency ng tubig is to flow, papunta doon, normally, through the two aquifer, yung dalawang ano, non-homogeneous and confined aquifer. Non-homogeneous, meaning to say, magkaiba ng property ang soil 1 and soil 2. Okay, so magkaiba ang K1 and K2 nila. Okay, so yan, makukuha natin yung K. So, kasi yung target value natin is Q eh. So, kunin natin si K, equivalent, ito yon. And yung I, ito naman yon. Ganun din sa pagkuha kanina, difference of the water table over the length traveled by water on the soil, ano? So, yun yung hydraulic gradient. So, D1 minus D2 over L. And yung ating cross-sectional area, ito, yan, cross-sectional area, ayun. So, D1 plus D2, average, D1 plus D2 over 2 times 1 unit length. Okay? So, yun. So, lagi nyo tatandaan, kapag yung parallel flow, ito, ang gamit, multiply siya. Kapag naman, normal flow, yan yung gamit. So, i-divide siya. Say, length over K. Basta over K, ano? Over K. And next, so, meron tayong tinatawag na continuity equation for simple flow problems. Ano? So, let's say, for example, meron tayong constant head test. So, parehas itong coarse grain soil. So, ang ginamit na process is constant head test. So, constant yung tubig dyan sa may gripong yan. And the tendency of soil is papunta pababa hanggang mapunan lahat yan. Lahat ng mga, anong yan, two pipe na yan. And ang target value natin dyan is makuha yung ating mga discharge, ano, discharge. So para makuha yung discharge, kailangan natin ng coefficient of permeability equivalent times I, hydraulic gradient, and the area kung saan nag-travel yung ating tubig. So, ang una, ang figure na ito, ayan. So, ito yung soil sample, dalawa. Soil 1 and soil 2. Ito namang nasa taas na itim na yan ay porous stone yan. Porous stone. Okay. And meron tayong mga pipe, nilagyan ng mga pipe para masukat yung mga head ng bawat ano tubig. And then, ipo-flow lang siya, constant head, hanggang sa mag-constant din dito, tuloy lang yung bagsak ng tubig dito. And ito magko-constant din, constant, hanggang sa mag-constant to, tuloy ang daloy ng tubig, hanggang papunta doon. Okay, then hanggang sa mag-constant din to, like constant head test tayo eh. Okay, ngayon, consider the one-dimensional flow problem shown. The following calculations may be applied. Okay. So, for the entire system, buong system ha. So, kasama si soil 1 and soil 2.
Okay, yung ating total flow is ito. Kia, equivalent coefficient of conductivity, permeability multiplied by the hydraulic gradient times the cross-sectional area. Okay, nung dinaanan. Okay, so para makuha yan, kailangan nating makuha yung equivalent hydraulic conductivity, which is ito. Yan. So, gamitin natin yung ating knowledge kapag parallel flow and normal flow. So, in this figure ay normal. Okay, normal flow siya. Ayun o. Normal flow. Pero kung ang kanyang layer is paganito, paganyan, paganyan, magkaibang layer, tapos yan, paganyan. So, parallel flow siya. Parallel flow. Okay? So, the total head, oh, okay. So, entire system, total head. Dito tayo titingin sa pinakanilabsan at saka pinagpasukan. Yung total head niyan is ito. So, H. H yung total head. H. And the total length of the soil. H1 plus H2 yun. Yun yung ating magiging total length. Or H. No, H1 plus H2. Yun yung total length. Okay, kasi entire system. Entire system eh. So, H1 plus H2. And the hydraulic gradient. So, yung H difference in head nung tubig. Nung inlet and outlet over yung the length of the sump, length kung saan nag-travel yung soil. Saan ba nag-travel yung soil? Diba dun sa H1 plus H2. Tama. H1 plus H2. Dito nag-travel eh. And the difference in head or water table is ito. Yan. So, H. Small letter H. Yeah. Okay. And the equivalent K using the relationship kapag normal flow is yan. So, yung total H natin is H1 plus H2. Tama, yung total length natin travel over yung equivalent. Equivalent coefficient of permeability. Kasi ang target natin makuha is ito. Okay? Para makuha ito. Kasi nakuha na natin yung I. Okay na. Yung A naman is given yan, cross-sectional area ng ating soil. And itong K sub equivalent na yan, makukuha natin using this formula. Okay, so given to, given to, given to, given to. Given yan, given yan. So ito na lang yung wala, so makukuha natin yan. So pag nakuha natin yung tatlo, ito, ito, at saka yung area, substitution, kuha natin yung total flow. Total flow of the water on the soil 1 and soil 2. Okay. So, ngayon naman, paano naman at point A? At point A, kasi yung ating flow, iisa lang naman yan eh. Yung total flow dito, iisa lang yan. Yung nag-flow dito, yung discharge dyan, yung discharge dito is also the discharge at this point, is also equivalent the discharge at this point. So, kaya nga continuity equation yun. Continuity equation ang hinahanap natin. Ano? Yan. And, same lang din ang pagkuha at point A. Kasi at point A, ito yung point A natin. Okay, so yung ating length ng soil is H1 ba? So, hindi. Ito. Ito lang yung length ng soil natin, Y1. Y1. Kapag at point A, ano? At point A. At point A. Yan. So, sa gitna. Yung paglagay ng ano, nung pipe ay sa gitna ng soil sample 1. Okay? Yan. And, so at point A, yung length natin is equivalent to Y1. So, as I've said. And the hydraulic conductivity, therefore, is H2 over Y1. So, yung head natin, bakit naging H2? So, yung difference, sabi ko nga, difference of the water table of the inlet hanggang doon sa pipe kung saan nandun yung ating point A. Okay, so H2 yung ating head. Okay, so yung hydraulic gradient natin at point A is equivalent to H2 over Y1. And the permeability is yun lang, K1. Hindi naman ang inaano natin, na-analyze natin at point A eh. So hindi naman hanggang doon na, hanggang dito lang tayo. Yung pagdaloy ng tubig papunta doon, ano? Papunta doon eh. Okay. Punta doon. Okay. Yan. So, yung flow, yung permeability, K1, tama? So, yung flow is also kaya pa din, KIA. Kaya lang yung K1, yung K natin is only dun sa soil 1 lang. Sa soil 1. K at soil 1. And hydraulic gradient at soil 1. And area ng soil 1. So, equivalent yan sa ating discharge at A. And using continuity equation is stating this. QA is equivalent to total flow. Sabi ko nga kung ano yung nag-discharge dito sa dito. Kung anong discharge dito is also the same as the discharge dito. Total flow. Okay, ganun din dito sa at point B. So, kunin lang natin yung H or the head kasi kailangan natin yung hydraulic gradient H over the length of the travel of water. Ano? Yan. So, yung head natin is this time is kasi sa point B na tayo dito. Sa point B. Sa point B. Yung head natin is a difference of the water here and hanggang dito. Sa pipe dyan. So H sub 3 yan. So yan yung head natin. And yung length nung tinravel ng tubig is hanggang doon. Ito. Ano ba yung length niya? So H1 plus Y2. H1 plus Y2. Kaya naging ganyan na. H1 plus Y2. So H over 3 over H1 plus Y2 will be the hydraulic gradient at point B. And the permeability natin, yung K equation, equivalent permeability natin. Bakit naging equivalent? Kasi soil 1 and soil 2 na yung dinaanan. Dito na siya. And yan, papunta doon. So, dyan na yung dinaanan. Ano? So, yung ating permeability is ganun pa din, normal flow pa din. So, divide H over K. Okay? H over K. But dito sa ating, at point B, so yung length lang na dinaanan is H1 plus Y2 over K equivalent at point B, ano? And that is equal to H1 over K1 plus Y2 over K2. Yung H1 natin for soil 1. Yung H2, Y2 natin is only for soil 2. Kasi at point B. At point B tayo. Yun. Then, the discharge at point B is equivalent to kia again. So, coefficient of the permeability equivalent at point B multiplied by the hydraulic gradient I sub B multiplied by cross-sectional area. Okay. And makukuha natin itong Q at B and also equal siya sa total flow. Okay? And also equal din siya sa Q at A. Q at A, okay? Yan. So, next topic is the hydraulic of wells. Pag sinabing wells ay balon, ano? Hydraulic of wells. Mga deep well natin dyan. Okay. So, underground water constitutes an important source of water supply. So, kaya dito sa Mindoro, ano? So, madaming free flow. Free flow. Baka nagtataka kayo bakit lumalabas yung tubig eh. Wala namang ano, pump, ano? So, that is because ay merong pressure sa ilalim.
Okay, kapag meron, ang tawag doon ay artesian well, ano? Artesian well. So, may pressure sa ilalim. Pero pagka yung gravity well, yung water table is, yun lang yung level ng tubig dun sa ating balon. Kaya mangyayari is, wala. Stable lang siya doon. Hindi siya mag-flow, ano? Kaya, kung mapapansin nyo, di ba, pagka yung pre-flow, ay babaon kayo ng tubo na ano ba, tatlo, mababa pa yon, so wala pa dun sa mismong pinaka confined aquifer natin na kung saan ay may pressure na dun, confined layer. Okay, yan ay kapag naman dun sa ano, walang pressure ay hindi mahihigit yung tubig pataas, ano. So ang tendency is kailangan pa nating magbaon ng tubo. Okay? Ngayon ang pag-aaralan natin doon is di paano ba yung takbo ng tubig doon sa mga layer ng lupa, ano. Okay. So the stratum of soil in which this water is present is known as an aquifer. Yun yung sinasabi ko. Aquifer, ano? On the basis of their hydraulic characteristics, wells are divided into two categories. So may dalawang type ng well tayo. So based dun sa ating hydraulic characteristic. Okay, so una is the gravity or the water table wells. Okay, water table wells, and the artesian or pressure wells. So, yung ating best example niya, yung mga airflow natin dyan sa mga kabukiran, ano, yan. Artesian or pressure wells yan. Yung ating pre-flow, ano. So, malalim na ang tubo nun. Yun namang mga deep well natin, yung mga dimakina, deep pump. So, ito yun, water table wells yan. Okay, kailangan pa ng pump para makuha yung tubig. Okay? Next, if the pressure at the surface of the surrounding underground water is atmospheric, the well is of gravity type. Yun na yung sinabi ko kanina, no? Kapag yung water pressure is atmospheric, yung, di ba, 760 mmHg yung atmospheric pressure natin. If the pressure daw ay ganun din, so meaning yung ating type ng well is gravity well or water table well. And while if this pressure is above, okay, kapag daw yung pressure sa ilalim is above atmospheric, ibig sabihin ay ang tendency niya is magbuga. Above eh, above pressure. Okay, kung 760 mmHg or sabihin natin na 101.3 kilopascal, di ba, yung ating atmospheric pressure. Ay ngayon, kung mas malaki yung nasa ilalim na pressure, ang tendency ng tubig is bumuga, ano, kaya nagkakaroon tayo ng mga pre-flow dyan, ano. Okay, an impervious soil stratum overlies the aquifer. The well is artesian. So nangyayari lang naman 'yon kapag halimbawa ito yung layer ng tubig natin. Yan, ito yung layer ng tubig natin. And then meron ditong impervious soil stratum. Impervious soil stratum sa ibabaw ng water table ng katubigan. And then dito meron din. So mangyayari is magkaka-pressure itong layer na to. Magkaka-pressure yan. Kapag tumuso ka ng tubo dito, so, ang tendency niyan is umakyat yung tubig. Kasi nga, yung pressure dun sa ilalim is above the atmospheric pressure. Okay? Assume that the water surrounding a well has a horizontal surface under static conditions. Okay? The lateral flow of water toward the well requires the existence of a hydraulic gradient, this gradient being caused by a difference in pressure. So to create this difference in pressure, The surface of the surrounding water assumes that the shape of an inverted cone. So, ganito yung itsura na. Ganito. Kapag gravity well, ganyan. Okay. Kapag naman artesian well, ganyan. So, kulang pa nga. Ayan. Artesian well, ano. Ito yung thickness of the uncompied, yung matigas na ano. Ayan. So, yung tubig niyan is nandito pa. Dapat nga meron pa dito yun eh. Ayan. Para magkaroon ng pressure. Confined aquifer, dalawa. Okay. Para magkaroon ng pressure. So, artesian well kasi yun. Ano? Unlike dito sa gravity well na yung water table is static. Ano? Andito na. Andiyan yung water table. Okay. So, so yung gravity well yan. Ang target natin dito is makuha yung average discharge. Average discharge doon sa ating soil ano, seepage kumbaga. Seepage discharge. Okay. And seepage discharge. And nasa na tayo? To create the difference, so yung cone. Cone. Ito yung inverted cone daw na sinasabi na magiging flow of during the pump of the well habang pinapump yan, pag pinump yan, doon ang tubig, ang tendency niya is pa ganyan. Ganyan. Yung maging tag dito. Maging linya ng tubig sa ating soil. As shown in the figure profile, this cone is known as the cone of depression. Cone of depression. Ayan, cone of depression. The cross-section of the cone at the water surface is called the circle of the circumference. Okay, yung cross-section of the ano daw. Okay, the circle of circumference. Circle of influence, rather. And the distance through which the water surface is lowered at the well is termed the drawdown. Okay, yung distance daw through which the water surface is lowered, kung na bumaba, drawdown. Okay, itong yung distance daw na yan, pamula dito, hanggang dun sa pagbaba, yun yung drawdown. Okay, drawdown. And the discharge corresponding to a drawdown of 1 meter is called the specific capacity of well. So the discharge daw, yung discharge Q, corresponding to the drawdown 1 meter, is called the capacity, specific capacity of the well. Okay. So, yung discharge niya, so, ayan. So, itong H1 is the distance pamula dun sa ating inverted cone. And ito namang R, yun yung distance ng H1 pamula dun sa center. Yung R2 naman, yun yung distance ng ating nitong may H2 na ito. H2. Okay. So, gravity well yan. So, para makuha yung discharge, average discharge, ayan yung formula na sa baba. So, ang target lang natin is ma-recognize yung ating gravity well. Alin ang R1, alin ang R2, alin yung H1 and H2. Okay? So, yung R1 is the distance from the center up to the H1. Okay? So, hanggang dun din. Yung R2 naman, dito naman. So, direct substitution, pag nakuha niya yung mga value na yan. So, yung pi is 3.1416 kasi bilog naman yan. Well tayo, bilog. Okay? Then, yung K is the coefficient of permeability K ng soil. Ano? Okay, and then H2 squared minus H1 squared. Ito yung dalawa. Ito yun. So, from the bottom of the well, hanggang dun sa ating cone. Yung cone. Okay, and over ln R2, ln of R2 over R1. So, yung R1 is the distance from the center of the well hanggang dun sa H1. Ayan, as you can see in the figure. Okay, so how about the artesian well? So, ang pinagkaiba lang naman nila is merong confined aquifer. Confined aquifer, yan yung thickness nung halimbawa, yan yung pinaka ano ba, pinaka hindi siya tinata inaanuhan ng tubig, kaya hindi siya dinadaluyan ng tubig, kaya nangyayari ay nagkaka-pressure. Okay, nagkaka-pressure. So, dapat ito, meron din ditong layer din dyan. Okay, itong layer naman na to ay yan yung ating may tubig. Okay? So, ang nabago lang yung formula. So, this time ay magkakaroon lang ng thickness. And, ta times natin ng 2. So, ito na yun, oh. So, halos same lang yung formula, kaya lang nagkaroon lang tayo ng thickness of the confined aquifer. Okay, and then 2 pi times 2. 2 pi k times t times h2. Kung naka-squared dito, kapag yung gravity well, so this, dito naman sa kabila, kapag artesian well, is walang squared. Walang squared, ano? Yan. So, direct substitution lang din once na nailagay natin yung mga given values and also the unknown values kung may kailangang hanapin. Just like yung ating mga K. Ano? Yan. So, substitute lang dito. Yan. So, where H1, H2, R1, R2 are in meters. Matandaan. Laging in meters. Are in meters, and the K, coefficient of permeability in meter per hour. Okay, meter per hour. Okay, and the discharge is cubic meter per hour. Yung makukuha nating sagot is cubic meter in cubic meter per hour. Okay, ganun din dito sa kabila. Cubic meter per hour. So, kapag sa problem, illustrative problem, ay mas madali na natin maunawaan yan. So, lecture notes lang muna. So, next is two-dimensional flow of water through soil. Okay, so, ito kasi yung kanina is one-dimensional lang, ano? One dimension, parallel, at saka normal flow. So, one-dimensional. Ngayon, pinagsama. So, may parallel, may in x direction and also in y direction. So, paano yon? So, flow nets. Seepage losses through the ground or through earth dams and levees. And the related flow pattern and rate of energy loss or dissipation of hydrostatic head are frequently estimated by means of a graphical technique known as flow net. Okay, so mamaya makikita natin. So, flow net is a graphical representation of a flow field that satisfies Laplace's. So, yung mga Laplace equation and comprises a family of flow lines and equipotential lines. So, yung flow lines, yan yung linya kung saan dadalo yung ating tubig. Yung equipotential lines naman, yan naman yung ating lines kung saan yung potential energy is the same, constant, ano. So, ito yung ating flow nets, kung tawagin, ano. Meron dyan, ito either levee, dams, or strat, mga ganun, ano. So, ang pag-aaralan natin, ang kukunin natin is yung paano dumadalo yung tubig dyan. May tubig dito sa kabila and may tubig din dito sa kabila. Okay? So, alamin muna natin, ano ba yung flow net na yan? Ano ba dapat masatisfied para maano yan, magamit yung formula na yan? A flow net must meet the following criteria. The boundary conditions must be satisfied. Okay, yan yung mga boundary na yan. So, flow lines must, ang flow lines dyan, ang flow lines ay ito. Yan, at yan. Yan ang flow lines. Yun namang ating equipotential line ay ito. Okay? So, nandito yung tubig, syempre, yung ating, nandito yung tubig, nandito din yung isang tubig. Syempre, ang tendency is pa ganun yung flow. Okay? And then, yung equipotential line na yan, dyan yung ating, yung potential energy is the same. Okay, flow lines must intersect equipotential lines at right angles. Dapat, eskwalado ang kanilang intersection. Okay? No, intersection ng equipotential line and the flow line ay dapat eskwalado. Okay? Right angles. So, number 3 criteria, the area between flow lines and equipotential lines must be curvilinear square. Okay, yung area daw nito, ayan, ano ba nitong, saan ba to? Sa 2. Ito, sa, ito, ano ba ito? Ay, yan, yung area daw niyan ay curvilinear square. Curvilinear square. Yung square siya na naka-curve. Okay? Parang ganon. Na kapag nag-drawing ka ng inscribed circle dyan, ay matatouch niya lahat yung sides. Okay? Kasi yun ang sabi dito. Matatouch niya. A curvilinear square has the property that an inscribed circle can draw to touch each side of the square. And continuous bisection results in the limit in a point. Sa paapat na criteria, the quantity of flow through its flow channel is constant. Okay, quantity of flow through its flow channel is constant. Okay, pare-parehas yung ating constant quantity of flow sa bawat channel. Okay. Bawat channel. Okay, the head loss between each consecutive equipotential line is constant also. So, yung ating head loss ay dun sa magkakasunod na equipotential line is constant. Ito yung equipotential line natin. Ayan. Yung pressure drop daw dyan is dapat equal. Equal. Ayan. So, the next criteria, a flow line cannot intersect another flow line. Ang flow line natin is ito. So, hindi pwede mag-intersect pa ganun. Hindi pwede ganun, ha? Yan. Yun yung ating flow net. Okay, and also, an equipotential line cannot intersect another equipotential line. So, hindi din pwedeng mag-intersect yung equipotential line na hindi pwedeng gumanon. Okay. Uy, nag-intersect. Ay, mali. So, the flow line is the path followed by a particle of water as it moves through a saturated soil mass. Okay. So, yung flow line, dyan mag, yun yung pattern ng tubig. Dyan yun magpo-flow. Ba, may dam dito. Dam. Gab yun, o ba, gab yun. Ito yung tubig natin. Yung tubig natin dito sa ilalim is yung pattern is pa ganyan. Yan. Yun yung magiging pattern niya papunta doon. Yan. Okay. And the equipotential line is a line connecting points of equal potential energy. Equal potential energy. Yan yung mga line na yan.
magkakaparehas ang potential energy. Diyan. Okay? So, the flow of water through isotropic soil is... So, pag sinabing isotropic soil ay homogeneous. Okay? Yung physical property ng ating soil is the same. Okay? Pare-parehas. Isotropic eh. Ibig sabihin, yung kanyang coefficient of permeability or the hydraulic conductivity is only one. One lang. Okay? Kapag naman anisotropic, eto, ganito, anisotropic, yung coefficient, ibig sabihin, not homogeneous siya. Yung physical property ng ating soil is not the same, is not constant. So, meaning yung ating K, yung coefficient of permeability is magkakaroon ng dalawa. K sub Z and K sub X. Magkaiba. Okay? Yan. So, yan. So, ang formula para makuha yung the flow ng water or yung discharge using the flow net graph ay yan. Q is equals to K, coefficient of permeability. Yung H naman, yung H is the difference in water elevation pa din. Ganun pa din. Water elevation H. And then yung NF, yan yung number ng ating flow lines. Kung ilang flow line dito, limbawa dito, ilan ang flow line dito? Ilan ang flow line? Isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima. So, five. Five flow lines. So, ito na yun. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five flow lines. So, yun yung ating NF. Yung ND naman, yan yung ating number of the equipotential line. Okay? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, meron tayong 10 N sub D. Okay? 10. Layer ha, layer. Hindi yung line. Layer ito. First layer, second layer, third layer, fourth layer, fifth, sixth, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay. Layer. Okay. ND. So, where? So, pinaliwanag ko na yung K, coefficient permeability, yung H, yung ating head, or the difference in the elevation of waters. Okay. Elevation of water, no? Okay, yung N sub F naman, number of flow channels. Pag sinabing channels ay yung layer mismo. Layer, ito. Ganito, ito. First layer is ito. Yan, first layer, yan. So, second layer ay ito. Diyan dadalo. Yung dinaluyan ng tubig. Channel. Second layer, third layer or third channel is ito. 2, 3, 4, 5. So, fourth layer is ito. Dinaluyan ng tubig. Padalawang layer, limang layer is ito na, yung nasa labas. So, kaya meron tayong limang layer dito sa figure 3.12 na yan. Okay? Yan. So, yung ND natin, number of equipotential drops. So, pinaliwanag ko na kanina. Ito yung equipotential drops natin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, meron tayong 10 equipotential drops. Okay, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so NF over ND is called the shape factor. NF over ND is the shape factor. Okay. So kapag anisotropic, ito yung formula, anisotropic soil ha. And kapag isotropic soil, homogeneous yung ating ano, ito yung formula. Okay. Yan. So ayun, next video ay yung ating mga sample problem ano. So thank you and have a good day.